सो हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द आउटब्रेक ऑफ रेवोल्यूशन, इन विच आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट हाउ द किंग हैव पास्ड अ न्यू फाइनेंशियल लॉ एंड हाउ द मेंबर ऑफ द थर्ड स्टेट वर डिस्क्रिमिनेटेड बाय द फर्स्ट स्टेट एंड द सेकंड स्टेट। सो ऑल दिस आफ्टर ऑल दिस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन द मेंबर ऑफ द थर्ड स्टेट दे प्लेस्ड टू ड्राफ्ट अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फॉर फ्रांस एंड द कमिटी विच वॉज द हेडिंग दिस ड्राफ्टिंग ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वॉज कॉल्ड अ नेशनल असेंबली and the leaders were from the first state and the second state, like the clergy and the nobles. And after the constitution was drafted, the citizens were divided into two, the active citizens and the passive citizens. The active were who were allowed to vote and the passive who were not allowed to vote. Passive included majorly women and the children. And after the constitution was drafted, then the power of the king was unchecked and a new federal form of government, like the federal government, was formed, which included the legislative, the executive and the judiciary. So basically the power of the king was unchecked. So today's aim is to discuss about France abolished monarchy and became a republic. So how France abolished monarchy? So the power of the king was kept under check in the outbreak of the revolution, as I've told. So definitely the king want the ultimate, the source of power should be within his hand only. So as the power was now distributed, so Louis XVI wants that power to come back to him. So for this, he wanted to secret negotiation with the king of Prussia. Means he allowed the king of Prussia, like he might have thought that he would allow the king of Prussia to attack France. So that all this system, the federal government system, was broken and the ultimate source of power would again be under his hand only. So the Louis XVI went into secret negotiations with the king of Prussia. But before this could happen, before a war could be declared by the Prussian France, on April 1792, the France declared war against Prussia and Austria. Now here I want to show you something. So here I want to show you that the neighboring countries of France. So here we can see Austria is there and Italy is there. From, as I've said, this is the north of a country. Here is the pointer. This is the north and this is the south. So, and this is the east and this is the west. As you can see, so the northeastern side is surrounded by Italy, Switzerland, and the north, like the southeastern, sorry, and the northeastern are surrounded by the Belgium, Germany, and from the west we can see, like here we are having a sea surrounding France, and from the west, south or southwest, we see here is Spain. So we can see the neighboring countries of France, and it is very important to know that which countries surrounds France, because if we want to see like the relation of the country with other countries, like we want to see the relation of India with Pakistan or the India with any other its neighbor, so definitely we will see the countries which are neighboring India, and from that only we can take an idea that by reading the history and comparing it with the present, we can understand the relation of a particular country with its neighbor. So we can see the neighboring countries of the France. So coming back to the topic, so on April 1792, France declared a war against Prussia and Austria. As I have said, the king went into secret negotiations, and before this could happen, France themselves declared a war against Prussia and Austria. Means the constitutional assembly which was formed, they declared a war against Prussia and Austria. So people from themselves volunteered to the fight. Like army was there, but people who were the civilians, they themselves volunteered to go into fight. So when the people, like majority men will only go to fight, so when all the men or the majority of the men went to fight, so during the war political club came into actions. Like political clubs were like different places. Like at a particular place, a certain discussion that would happen regularly of regarding discussing about the government policies or the government different bills which government bring. So the political club came into actions and they became a point of discussion about government policies. So the successful among them were the Jacobin club, which got the name from Saint Jacob. Like there were different, as I've said, many political club might be formed, and the successful among them was, successful means the popular among them was was the Jacobins club. And here we see a twist after in the next video I will tell you that how Jacobin Maximilian Robespierre, who is Maximilian Robespierre, we will also learn here only. So members of the Jacobin were from the less prosperous family. Like definitely people from the third estate, like those were the actual taxpayers, they were only discussed about, not the government policies. So the majority of them were from the third estate, from the less prosperous family, like the peasants, the artisans. So the leader was Maximilian Robespierre. Note the name Maximilian Robespierre. They also wear a hat, and one thing is a mistake here. So sorry friends, there was a little mistake here. So the Jacobins used to wear the striped pants, like the member of the Jacobin, the club, the Jacobin. So their members used to wear a striped pants. They also used to wear a red hat, which symbolizes liberty. So again, I want to show you something. Like these are the Jacobins, we can see. Like see, these are the Jacobins people. As you can see, they are wearing striped pants. They are wearing the strip band, as you can see there is line in their pants, and they are wearing the red hat. So this picture is for you so that you can remember well. So they used to wear the strip pants and the red hat. Now why they used to wear a red hat? They used to wear a red hat which symbolizes liberty. Liberty from whom? Liberty from the mindset of the people, that the third estate people are less educated or are not wealthy or are not, you know, to their class, we can say. So on the morning of August 10, a mob of angry people stormed. Now here the situation changes. So on the morning of August 10, a mob of angry people stormed in the palace and made the king hostage. Hostage means bandak. So the people were angry from the king from earlier also, like the price of the bread was so much high. And when they came to know that the king was in the secret negotiation with the king of Persia, so they definitely become angry because it was like a betrayal from their country. So they become angry from the king, and many people, like a mob means thousands of people, because definitely they are going to make hostage to the king. So many people, they attacked the palace and made the king hostage, means they made the king bandak there only. So at that time, a newly elected assembly was called convention. Like the name of the national assembly was changed to convention, the national convention. So the national convention made certain changes. What the changes they made were, they allowed the right to vote for everyone above 21. Like the previously, only the, as I've said, the active citizens, like those who were the taxpayers, those who can pay the tax of up to 3 days, and the mans of the third estate also, those who can pay the tax up to the 3 days, they were allowed to vote, and the women were not allowed to vote. So now, like in our country also, all those who are above 18 have the right to vote. So they made everyone who was above 21 the right to vote, and each vote has its own value. So finally on 21 Jan 1793, Louis XVI was sent to jail. As you know, that he was hostage. He was in the hostage by the people. So on 21 Jan 1793, Louis XVI was sent to jail. Now I want to show you certain pictures. Like this was a situation, like the peoples of the third estate or the National Assembly drafting constitution. We can see how they drafted a constitution in front of, you know, a palace or any big monument. These might be the leaders, and these might be the people those who were there to draft a constitution. And this is the palace of the Versailles, where the king used to hold its meeting. And the main cause of frustration, or that what causes the French Revolution, was the discrimination part. We can say the third estate was so much depressed, or there was so much pressure on the third estate, like discrimination was there, so much tax they have to pay. So as we can see, discrimination, like as you can see in the picture, all those who are sitting, like, see, they are facing each other. See, we can see they are facing each other. So these are the clergy and the nobles, and all those who are standing back. See, this might be the king, I'm not knowing. So these might be the people of the third estate, as they have to stand back. So this is all in the video. So thank you for watching.